Welcome back to our PostgreSQL series. Today we will be learning how to drop a database in PostgreSQL. But first, a disclaimer. Dropping a database is a permanent and irreversible operation that deletes all the data in the database. It is important to be absolutely certain that you want to drop a database before doing so. This tutorial is intended for educational purposes only, and we cannot be held responsible for any data loss or other issues that may arise from following these instructions. Always make sure to have a backup of your database before dropping it and practice this in a test environment before attempting it in the production. That being said, let's move on. Now, there are two scenarios for dropping a database. First, when the database is idle and no user is connected to it. Second, when the database is in use and some users are connected to it. We will explore both of these scenarios, but first, let me tell you how we actually drop a database. Deleting a database is a serious and irreversible action. Once you drop the database, you cannot undo it. So it's crucial to understand how to do it correctly. In PostgreSQL, we use the drop database command to delete a database. The syntax of this command is this, where drop database is a reserved command. And if exist is an optional clause that tells the PostgreSQL engine not to throw an error if the database doesn't exist. And then we have the name. It is the name of the database that we want to drop. Now that we have seen the syntax, let's move on to the demonstration of how to properly delete a database.
There are two main restrictions that we need to check before dropping the database. First, only a super user or the owner of the database can drop the database. Second, there should not be any user connected to the database that you want to drop. If there is any, then you must connect to a different database or terminate the connection before dropping the database. I will demonstrate to you how to do that.
Since either the database owner or a super user can drop a database, we must make a choice. In this case, I will opt for the latter and connect to my database using a super user named Postgres. I will be using the Windows command prompt to execute the command. If you are using Linux or Mac, you can use the terminal since the command and process are the same. Before proceeding, make sure that the Docker container that has your PostgreSQL is up and running. Here is my Docker desktop app, and this one is the container that I am talking about. Let's run it. Great. Let's close this Docker desktop app now. Now let's connect to our PostgreSQL using Postgres user. Postgres_img is the name of my Docker container into which I have installed the PostgreSQL. This could be different in your case. PSQL is the command we need to run from the container. By using the -u option, we specify the name of the user we want to use to connect to the database. In my case, that's Postgres. This command will connect us to the default database whose name is Postgres using the super user whose name is also Postgres. Let's execute. We are connected. Now let's move on to the scenario I mentioned earlier, beginning with the first one. If the database is idle and no user is connected to it, we can simply drop the database without any additional effort. Don't worry, I will show you how to check if users are connected to the database or not in the next scenario. So to drop the database demo 1, the drop database command will look something like this. I begin the command with the phrase drop database and then specify the clause if exists. This clause checks if the database demo 1 exists and drops it if it does. If the database does not exist, then the command will have no effect and will not return an error. Finally, I specified the name of the database I want to drop, which in my case is demo 1. Let's execute. Database drop. To demonstrate this scenario, I will drop another database named demo 2. For this demonstration, I will create a scenario where I will first connect to the demo 2 database. The purpose of doing so is to show you that the demo 2 database is not idle and a user is connected to it. Let's do that.
This statement will connect me to the database demo 2 using the user Postgres. Let's execute. Great, now I'm connected to the database demo 2. I will now show you how to check if a database is idle or not. If it is not and some users are connected to it, then I will demonstrate how to terminate those connections before dropping the database. I will now switch over to VS Code and execute a command to check if there are any users connected to this database. If there are any active connections, I will demonstrate how to terminate them. Now, here in the VS Code, I am connected to my database named Postgres with the super user whose name is also Postgres. By the way, I have done a video on how to connect with database using VS Code. So if you want, you can check that also. Link on your screen as well as in the description. Anyways, to check if there are any active connections, I will query the pg_stat_activity_view. Here is how.
Let's run the query.
The result clearly show that one user is connected to the database and the name of that user is demo2 with a process ID of 105. We will use this information to terminate the connection. To do this, we will once again use the pg_stat_activity_view. Here is how. In this query, we are executing the pg_terminate_backend function of the pg_stat_activity_view. We are specifying the 105 as the argument since it is the PID of the active connection that we want to terminate. In the where clause, we are filtering the result to only include record for the demo2 database. This ensures that only connection to that database are terminated. Let's execute. Done. Now, if you go to the command prompt where we are connected to the database demo 2 and try to execute any command, we should get an error. Let's check. Here I am on my command prompt. Let's run a meta command \l. This command will list down the name of all the databases. Let's execute. Great, we got an error. That means we have successfully terminated the connection. Now this database is idle and we can drop it. Let's do that. But first, let's close this command prompt and get back to our VS Code. Here we are. Let's write drop database command here. Let's execute. Database dropped. That's how we terminate an active connection and drop a database.
I hope you found this video helpful. If so, please give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to the channel. Also, don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notifications for our future videos. Thank you for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.